Looking forward to that, but you know, looking right at the sun during that event without the proper protection, you could actually go blind.
So our Eileen Park joins us live now with more on how to keep your eyes safe during the eclipse. Eileen?
Jeff, your regular sunglasses are not going to cut it. If you plan on looking at the eclipse, you're going to need special glasses.
Anytime you're looking directly at the sun,
these are designed with mylar and polymer.
You need extra protection.
And they need to be certified.
Okay.
You know, you can't just get ordinary sunglasses or any other devices that you consider to be sun filters.
Inside the planetarium at OMSI, Jim Todd was explaining how the moon blocks the sun, creating the eclipse we all can't wait to see in August. But he tells me the dangers that lie with the monumental event.
If you don't wear the filters and you look at the sun more directly for 10 seconds, your eye can be permanently damaged.
Go ahead and use this to cover your left eye.
Andrew Aker is an optometrist at Visual Eyes in Portland.
The effects can last anywhere from a few seconds to minutes to days to weeks to months.
And explains how the sun damages your eyes.
It actually affects the retina, the tissue that lines the inside of the eye, which is responsible for converting light into what our brain can recognize as vision.
The only time you can look at the eclipse without any protection is when it's completely covered, and you have to be in an area of totality. If you're somewhere else, like in Portland, for example, you'll need to wear eclipse glasses the entire time.
The problem is that, you know, you see this event happening in the sky, so especially smaller children or people who just aren't in the know are going to want to be staring at it.
You can't just wear any eclipse glasses. They have to be specially certified. We put up several links on reputable places that you can buy them on coin.com. Back to you.